Imagine a world where there is no one to help you. You are separated from your family and constantly hunted by your own neighbors. Welcome to the life of Carl Stern. This is the Berlin Boxing Club, a 400-page historical novel written by Robert Chernow. Today we are going to hear from the key people involved in making this book. Present we have the author, Robert Chernow, protagonist, Carl Stern, and our book expert, Sajin, and our historian, Alicia. Okay, let's start off with you, Mr. Stern. Would you care to describe your childhood experiences in Nazi Germany?
I've been through a lot during my childhood. First of all, I'm a cartoonist. Drawing has taken me through a lot of my struggles and has helped me cope. My story starts with the day I started to get bullied for being a Jew. The problem was I didn't identify as a Jew because I was brought up as an atheist. Then I met the person that changed my life, Max Schmeling, a world-class boxer. He offered to teach me boxing, so I accepted because I could use these skills to fight off all the bullies. While boxing, I met my best friend Nebling and my biggest boxing supporter, Wurjik. Soon later, the violence started to increase for the Jews and I had to manage my priorities, either save my family, especially my sister Hildy, or continue boxing. Sadly, 2 years later, I was forced to quit boxing. I soon realized the world is worse than I thought and I can't prevent it.
Wow, that is really shocking. It is amazing that you have survived all of these things that you have been through. Unfortunately, your personal experience as a child is comparable to real-life atrocities. Alicia, can you compare the setting and plot of this book relative to a modern time in history?
It's the most similar to 1933 through 1938 interwar Germany. Following the appointment of Adolf Hitler as German Chancellor on January 30th, 1933, the Nazi state, also referred to as the Third Reich, quickly became a regime in which the citizens had no guaranteed basic rights. The Nazis' rise to power brought an end to the war mire. Republic, the German parliamentary democracy established after World War I. In 1933, the regime established the first concentration camps, imprisoning its political opponents, homosexuals, Jehovah's Witnesses, and others classified as dangerous. Extensive propaganda was used to spread the Nazi Party's racist goals and ideals. During the first 6 years of Hitler's dictatorship, German Jews felt the effects of more than 400 decrees and regulations that restricted all aspects of their public and
private. Similarities between the Berlin Boxing Club and the real-life Nazi regime from 1933 to 1938. The discrimination and persecution of the Jewish religion is one of the most defining traits of the Holocaust and the Berlin Boxing Club. To compare the two, I found a very meaningful quote from this book. "Organized fighting doesn't make any sense to me," she said. "Why would you want to let yourself get hurt if you didn't have to? And why would you want to hurt an innocent person who you're not even mad at, who you don't even know?" This quote is one of the most significant parts of the book. It may sound like a simple question about boxing, but on a deeper level, Mr. Chernow, it seems like your own criticism of the Holocaust. The Nazis, on one hand, are unspeakably inhumane to Jewish people and other minorities. On the other, nations are standing by and letting the Nazis oppress and persecute these groups. In my opinion, this quote is an ingenious way of alluding to real-life Nazi brutality and comparing it to the art of boxing. That is what makes this book so unique. Stating that, Mr. Chernow, can you go into more detail about your motivation for writing this book?
It all started when I found out about Max Schmeling, a real boxer in 1930s Germany. He was known for being the only German heavyweight champion and fought during the rise of the Nazi Party. The Nazis even called him typical of the Aryan ideal and claimed them as their own fighter. Despite the anti-Semitic actions of the Nazi Party, including banning Jews from participating in boxing as a fighter, trainer, or even a fan, Max refused to get rid of his Jewish trainer. Something I found of particular interest was an act of heroism of his during Kristallnacht, a night of terrible Nazi terror against the Jews. During Kristallnacht, he hid two Jewish boys in his hotel room, saving their lives, and later got them passage to the US. Max never spoke of this act, and it wasn't publicly known until the late 1980s. Max's acts of kindness and his humility inspired me to write the story partly based on him.
Thank you for telling us about your personal inspirations for Carl and his story. There is so much to learn from this book and your childhood experiences in Germany. Now let's hear from our book expert, Sajin. Sajin, you know the Berlin Boxing Club like the back of your hand. What did you enjoy about reading this book?
Carl is an accurate representation of how many Jews faced hardships and inequality during the time of the Nazis.
What was your favorite moment in the book?
My favorite moment in the book would have to be when Carl was kicked out of his school. It was a very shocking and nerve-wracking moment because as the principal, someone who is a leader, someone who has much power in the school, he called up Carl and many other Jews and he called them out for being something that they weren't.
That was a very memorable part to me as well. For our audience, would you care to give a rating for this book?
Look, out of 5, I would give it a 4.2. Now, 3 I would consider average, but it was not average because it explained the hardships Jews had to face during Nazi times. I would not give it a 5 because that would mean a perfect book, and I do not consider it perfect. However, I do agree that it should be higher than 4 because it developed a personal connection with Carl and how he explained that his hardships could be overcome.
All of our interviewees, there is a consensus that this is a very entertaining book. The plot is painfully realistic, the characters are uniquely relatable, and I can say without a doubt that I was on the edge of my seat until the very end. In the eyes of myself and our other guests, this book is a must read.